If you build it, they will come. Now, as much as I love that famous line from the movie Field of Dreams with Kevin Costner, this may not be an approach you want to take for your business. Market research is an important thing to do to feel confident that you're building something people value and want to buy and invest in. It's also an important activity that people miss all the time in order to validate their business ideas and the offers they want to create. And it can be such a helpful tool to use when you want to find that niche you want your work to belong to, if you took the time to market research effectively. But what if you don't have an existing audience or an email list to conduct this market research with? So in this video today, I'm going to show you how to gather great market research candidates, even if you don't have an audience yet, the best ways to conduct the market research, and show you a simple template that you can use today to invite ideal clients to a market research interview. Hey, thanks so much for joining me today. I am Lydia Lee, and I help budding entrepreneurs create their dream business without struggling with self-doubt, overthinking, and complicated strategies. So if you're looking to build a business you love, designed from your strengths, your values, and your personality, then be sure to hit the subscribe button and the bell button to continue tuning in for videos just like this one. Market research is such an important tool that we can use in our business because we don't have to create our business in isolation, to be lonely on the road to entrepreneurship. We need to do it with collaboration with the exact people who can be our ideal customers. And it makes it just a whole lot easier to create something that people have vocalized, right? Have expressed to you that they need and want. So when you can talk to ideal customers and pick their brains on the problems they want to get solved and how they want to reach their goals in an approach that works for them, you can create valuable solutions as a business owner to really serve their needs more effectively. And market research is not only important to understand your customer's point of view and their problems so that you can create a valuable offer, but it's also helpful to discover the words that they're using to describe their problems. This can be really tremendously helpful for you in the future when you think about marketing to them effectively. I want to start with a couple tips to help you to really conduct market research really effectively. Now, my favorite go-to way, right, to do market research is always with deep, meaningful conversations. One-to-one conversations are the most ideal. Now, there are other ways that you could be conducting market research through things like surveys, right? You could email out questions for people and get people to answer them. But I really find for the many years that I've been conducting market research every year for my business and also supporting my clients to conduct market research when they start a business, one-to-one conversations are honestly the most valuable insights that you're going to receive from people. Why? It's because people get to talk to you. You get to dig deeper. You get to ask them why they think the thoughts that they have, right? Kind of difficult when you do it in a survey and you have some information that you receive from people, but you aren't really to go, you know, get to go, why did you think that way? How did you try that thing that you tried before and it didn't work? What would you like more of when it comes to a better solution for you, right? Conversations, I think, are some of the most effective ways to do it because people are relaxed. They feel like it's a conversational format, which they feel that they can be honest and transparent with you. And it gives you a chance as a regular human being to really dig into areas that you feel would be really important for you to understand from the problems that they have. Secondarily, I think that one-on-one conversations really help to build trust with these customers. So these people that you might be interviewing for market research may also be ideal candidates for customers in the future, or maybe beta testing clients for some offer, right, that you might want to test out couple weeks, couple months down the road. Why not tap into the same well, right, that you've been drinking from when it comes to these market research candidates? So when people get to know you, they know your why, the purpose of you wanting to create this business, right, the generosity that you may give them in terms of advice and tips after that call, all the things that they really find out from you as a human and vice versa is really just going to create a much deeper bond and just a better relationship with a client like this. So one-to-one are the best ways to go ahead and do it. I also want you to make sure that you're able to record some of the data, right, and the insights that your customers are telling you in these market research interviews. Now, I love to record them, right? I use a tool called Zoom. You might have heard about it. It's sort of everywhere these days, right? Zoom gives you a chance to record the conversation, and you can have it in an audio file or a video file, and you can use it, right, to really pinpoint some interesting and important details that people have talked to you about in the research interviews. But always, always ask permission to record, right? This is really going to be a privacy matter. You could tell them that after you've listened to the conversation, after you've taken notes from the recording, you're going to delete that recording right away, and it's private between you and them. They can get a recording if they want it to. You can send it to them, but really just ask permission to record. Another tip I can give you to, if you're not someone that wants to listen and take notes from the interview, is to use a transcription tool like otter.ai or rev.com. Otter.ai will give you three free transcriptions every month, up to about 40 minutes per audio file, and anything more than that, you'll just pay a small fee monthly to get that service. Rev.com is an actual human, right, behind the software that's going to transcribe your conversations for you. And again, you pay a pretty small fee in order to do that. Now, transcriptions are really great because I can read really fast, faster than I can listen to a transcription, right? So it helps me to kind of pick up, you know, consistent languaging, things that people are saying, be able to highlight things right on the document. And that really allows me to really see some themes and some repeated problems, repeated obstacles that my customers are facing from multiple market research interviews that I'm doing. Now, if you want to find out more about what sort of questions you should be asking and why it's really important to really start market research before you start to create an offer or a service or a product for your business, don't forget to check out my free training called How to Launch a Business You Love. And that's going to have a section in there that you're going to learn how to market research and ask powerful questions from your audience. So if you don't have an email list, an audience, or any followers for your brand or your business right now, where do you find these people, right, to conduct market research with? Well, I want to start with kind of noticing and seeing who you can find through your low-hanging fruit network. And a low-hanging fruit network really are just communities and networks that you already know. And if you just pay attention to them a little bit, you might be able to find a couple or a handful of people to interview. And very, very likely, you know someone in your community, in your network, in your Facebook page right now, right, that are friends of yours or colleagues or people that belong in associations, right, or organizations you've worked with before, that might actually be someone you could connect with one-on-one to invite them on a market research interview. So I want you to take a couple minutes, maybe you can pause the video right now, just like make a list of people that you know who have maybe picked your brain before, right, on this problem that you know how to solve for your business, right? So if you are a health coach, for example, that have been sharing your health weight loss journey, or people have, talked to you a little bit about some accomplishments that you've had, right, in your life, who are these people? You're already giving out advice for free. You've already been sharing a lot of your insights and your knowledge in your own journey. Why not have this structured and more focused approach to actually share your ideas with them, but also pick their brains for once, right, on the problems that they have. So make a list of people who have already talked to you before that are potential, representations of your ideal client, or just anyone that has gotten some free advice from you. And this may be a way that they can return the favor by actually being a market research candidate for you. You can also make a list of people that you know, right? Whether it's family, friends, friends of friends, right? As I mentioned, these colleagues of people you've worked with before, people on your Facebook page, right? Of individuals that you can approach that you might know that are struggling with a problem that you can help with, and offer to do what I call like a 30 for 30 exchange, right? So you want to give and take when it comes to a market research interview. You want to be able to get from them information, right? Their pain points, their problems, how they perceive their issues, right? What they think about their problem, what they want to happen for their problem. And you're going to spend that time picking their brain. And then you can offer an exchange for their time by saying, hey, I've got some knowledge that might be helpful to you. I have expertise in this area that could be helpful to you. I'm happy to be generous with my time after and offer you an exchange of 30 minutes as well so that you can pick my brain on something that I can support you with. So the 30 for 30 exchange really allows you to be generous and it allows you to take something from them but being able to offer something back as well. Lastly, look for communities that you already belong to. These could be Facebook groups, it could be meetups, it could be your place of worship, it could be a membership that you already belong to that might hold a couple of ideal candidates that could represent your ideal client that you could reach out to in order to interview. You could either post on a Facebook group that, hey, you started this business, there's some information you want to receive and you would love to be able to exchange some advice back to them as well, right? If they come on that interview. If you're at a place of worship or an association you belong to, right? Perhaps you could make a call out in the bulletin board, right? Or really just touch base with people one-on-one and ask if they might be a good fit for you to belong to. So when you are posting on Facebook, asking for referrals. Maybe other people know someone that could be a great market research candidate for you. Or maybe you're emailing your friends or directly, right? Connecting with an individual to invite them on a market research interview. I want to share with you a quick template you can use so that you're not tongue-tied for words. It's short, it's simple, you can fill in the blanks. I'm going to walk you through it really quickly. And you can also download it in the link that I'm going to be putting up in the cards here on the video or at the description of this video so that you can get a hold of this template, fill in the blanks with what you need to make it customized for your business. And in that download, I'm also going to share with you a couple of variations of these short emails or short notes that you can send and pick one that's right for you. Here's a quick template you could use, an example of what you can write. And again, if you download the template from me in the descriptions link or the cards link, you'll be able to do this yourself with a couple of variety of letters and notes like this that you could send. So, hi Lisa, some exciting news. I started a side business this week. I'm still working at my 9-to-5 job, but I've decided to pursue my health coaching business on the side. My goal right now is to learn more about how women want to lose weight sustainably, build long-lasting changes, and honor the bodies they're in. I'm looking for individuals to have a meaningful conversation with so that I can really dig into the problems women face when navigating weight loss and healthy living. If you're someone or someone else you might know that is a good fit to talk to, I would love to invite you on a call. I'll spend 30 minutes asking you a few questions and I'll reserve 30 minutes for you to ask me any questions that can be helpful for you too. I have a ton of knowledge in holistic nutrition and sustainable weight loss insights and I would love to share them. I appreciate your support and look forward to hearing from you. Bye for now, Karina. So as you can see here, it tells people a bit about a why, right? The goal you're working towards and why you're having these interviews, what you're looking for, right? And how you are inviting them to a call or might get a referral from them. And just a bit of a structure, right? It's going to be 30 minutes, but it's a 30 for 30 exchange where you'll get to ask me more questions and hear the areas of knowledge that I can be helpful with. Okay, really easy. And again, you'll be able to download this yourself and do one of these templates for yourself to send off to market research candidates too. The practice of asking before you create anything is a tremendous practice to have, whether you are in your first year of business or your 10th year of business. I've been in business at this point for almost 7 years, and every single year, I use the practice of market research to understand my customers on a deeper level, figure out what they want to learn, which really helps me to create great content that actually resonates with them. And it also plants ideas and clues for me into what it is that they want to buy, what they value, and what it is that I might end up creating next for them. So whether you're creating an offer, whether you're trying to figure out what sort of content for blogs or videos that you want to film and create, asking, right, and going straight from the horse's mouth, which is your clients, and just getting that answer for them is such a much more collaborative way to build a business, right, that you're not feeling alone in doing it all, and you're going to feel so much more relieved and validated when people tell you exactly and directly what it is people, what it is that they want and what it is that they want to learn. So I hope that this really sparks some ideas for you on how to start your market research approach, find the ideal customers for you to conduct these market research with, and bring more clarity in what it is that you want to create as a service, and really look at the messaging, right? That languaging that people need to hear, right? How to describe their problems, how they want to talk about their pain points, and how that can really help you in creating marketing messages and really positioning your work, right, really powerfully by listening to your customers first. So if you did try any of these market research approaches I shared today, or if you're excited and inspired to try one of these things today, please share with me in the comments below this video why you think it'll be important for you to market research for your business as well, and what are you excited to learn? What are you trying to do market research for in order to grow your business? Do share it with me below. And as usual, thank you so much for spending time with me, and I will see you in next week's video. Thank you.